Hello guys, so welcome back to our sixth lecture. So we're gonna continue our discussion about Zenand and NOR gates, the newly discovered logic gates from the last lecture. Okay, so basically as we said, NAND is just not AND, and NOR is just not OR, okay? And it's not just that. Basically, using NAND or NOR gates in our circuit, in our logic design, you know, makes our design a lot easier. The design process or implementation process, we can say, okay? And why is that? Because of the special properties that NAND and NOR have over X, over AND or OR gate or inverter gates, okay? And you know, the secret in is that NAND and we can implement AND, OR, and NOT gates using NAND gate or NOR gate. Okay, we can implement basically any logic gates using NAND or NOR, as you will see in this video now. Okay, so what is the advantage of this? The advantage of this is that now, if instead of having in your design and the gates or gates, you know, inverter gates, no, you will have everything is NAND or everything is NOR. And that says it has, you know, this will lower the complexity of your design. Okay. And also in deep details, it will make your, you know, analysis easier for your design because, or the timing analysis easier because now everything is NAND. Okay, so you have only one delay in your circuit. Each gate has the same delay because all of them are NANDs. Although if you have mixed AND, OR, and NOT gates in your circuit, then you will have here a gate delay, you have here another gate delay because basically these are separate circuits, they are different circuits. So generally you don't have the same delay. But everything is now NAND, then you have the same circuit everywhere, so you have uniform delay, which will make your timing analysis easier, okay? Now the question is how to implement each gate, each logic gate we studied so far using NAND or NOR. So let's do that now. Okay, so let's start by the most easy one, which is NOT gate. So let's see. Basically, NOT has one input. Maybe this is the most hardest, the hardest one, because you know that the inverter has one input, but NAND has two inputs. Just look at the truth table here, X and Y, right? But the trick is that make the same input or this variable the same input for both inputs. And let's see what's gonna happen. So this is an AND gate. Okay, and this is a variable that we want to invert or complement. So it has two inputs. So just to connect X to both inputs. Okay, so we have here X and X, right? So the output will be X and X inverter. This with De Morgan's equal to X complement or X complement. And when you add something to it, to itself, it will give you the same stuff in Boolean algebra. So this will be basically equal to X bar. So that, so you can just consider this as a box. The input of that box was X. The output was X bar. So that's the inverter. Using NAND. Can we do the same using NOR? Yes. So let's see what's gonna happen if we just insert the same input to both inputs of the NOR gate. So we have X. X will be the same input for both. So you have here X, you have here also X. This will result in X or X inverter, complement for the whole bracket. This will be equal to using De Morgan's X bar dot X bar. When you AND something with itself, it will give you the same stuff. this will be x bar. So again, you can just enclose this gate into a box. The input of this box is x, the output is x bar. This is basically inverter. This is, you know, 1/5, 20% of our, you know, analysis now, because we have 5 gates. We have NOT, or the inverter, we have OR, we have AND, we have XOR, we have XNOR. We have 5 gates, and we're gonna implement these 5 gates using NAND or NOR gate, okay? This is 20% now. Let's now do the 80%. OR. So basically in OR, the function is X or Y. Okay, so the trick here is that for the NAND gate, just make the inputs X bar, Y bar. One may say, but now we need invert mod. But this is basically our first 20% because we could implement inverter using NAND gate, right? Okay, what would be the output of that NAND gate now? It would be X bar dot Y bar, and total will be inverted. Using De Morgan's, this will be X bar bar or Y bar bar. X inverter, inverter, Y inverter. So basically this will be cancel each other. So this will be X or Y, right? This is really nice. Can we do that using NOR? Yes, we can. Although that's very easy. So basically, you have here the NOR. Just now insert X and Y. Then X and Y, this will give you X or Y complement. This is the definition of NOR, right? Good. Now we want to invert this, but you know how to do the inverter using NOR. So basically, we need another NOR, and this will be the input to both inputs. So the output here would be X or Y complement or X or Y complement. And the total is complemented as well. So this will be give us X or Y complement complement dot X dot Y complement complement. So this is basically the complement will, the two complements will cancel each other. So this will give us X or Y dot X or Y, which is basically X or Y. I am doing it in a very, you know, in a very detailed way, but you can just look at, compare this with this. So this will be basically, the output will be basically the inverter of the input. So, but you know, just to make, to give you more insights, okay? Or to make you more confident. The AND, okay? So our, if we implement AND using NAND, it would be something similar to this. So basically, you have here the AND gate. Insert X and Y in it. The output would be X and Y inverted or complemented. Then do like this. We need an inverter. So we need another NAND. And its two inputs will be the same output of the first NAND. So the output here is just, you know, just look at here. It will be X and Y. Can we implement AND gate using NOR? Yeah, look at this. So this is, we're gonna make something similar to this here for the NOR. So we have here the NOR. That's basically the duality. You remember, guys, the duality principle that we talked about in our first or second week? This is basically the duality principle. So X bar, Y bar, And we know how to do X bar, Y bar using NOR. The output here is X bar or Y bar, and the total is complemented. Okay. And this is basically equal to using De Morgan's X bar bar dot Y bar bar. Two bars will cancel each other. So this is X Y or X dot Y. That's basically AND. Can we do the XOR? Yes, we can. So first, what is XOR? So XOR is a function if equal to X Y bar plus X bar Y. So let's construct them. So let's construct each term first. Okay, let's start by X, Y bar. This is an ANDing operation. And here is the ANDing operation of using NAND gate. Okay. So here is the first AND. X, Y bar. So the output here is X, Y bar and totally bar. Then we need to invert it. This will be X, Y bar. Second term, same stuff, X bar Y. And X bar Y. This will be X bar Y totally bar. Then another NAND. This will be X bar Y. Good. We constructed the two terms. Now we do the OR. So let's see how we construct OR using NAND. Here it is. Just one NAND, but we need to input to it the inverted inputs. So we need to invert or complement our inputs here, those two. So another NAND for the inversion. Another NAND for the inversion. So this will give us X, Y bar, totally bar. This will be, give us X bar, Y, totally bar. Then we input these two outputs to another NAND gate. So the output will be X, Y bar bar, ending with X bar Y totally bar, which is basically with De Morgan's theorem, this will be OR. The first term will be X, Y bar, totally bar, totally bar. Bar will go with the bar, X, Y bar. The second term will be X bar Y totally bar, another bar. Two bars will cancel each other, so we'll lift off with X bar Y, which is basically what exactly we want. That's XOR. Very nice. But actually, we need we can do much better than this. We can do much, much better than this. I mean, there is another implementation using NAND gates for XOR that will result in lower number of NANDs or NAND gates used. Just look at what we have here, okay? The first two outputs here are X, Y bar, totally bar, and X bar Y, totally bar, this one and this one. And look at the inputs for the last NAND gate. This guy here is X bar Y totally bar, which is basically this. And this one here, which is X, Y bar totally bar, is exactly this, right? So basically, we don't need the internal NANDs here. Those guys we are not need, we don't need. We can just ignore them. We can just, you know, remove them and just connect directly this output here to this input and this output here with this input. So why I did it in the first place? Because I was just, you know, doing it with you step by step in algorithmic way how to think about it. This is basically our first step in everything we study. After we accomplish something using that algorithmic thinking, then we look at our solution. Can we optimize it? Yes, we can. Then we get another correct solution, but optimized in a more optimized way. That's everywhere. So basically, the, you know, the optimal implementation is as follows. Let's do it with another color. For example, green, because it will be green design, because green things usually have less, you know, impact on the environment. So, and less cost and stuff. So the first NAND gate with inputs as X and Y bar. Second NAND gate with X and with X bar Y. So the output here is X, Y bar, totally bar. This is X bar Y, totally bar. Then we take these two outputs and put them into another NAND gate. So the output here will be this stuff here. X, Y bar bar dot X bar Y bar, which is basically X and total bar, which is basically X, Y bar plus X bar Y. Okay, guys. That's the final one. That's the optimum implementation or optimum design, we can say. Now, how to do that using, how to implement XOR using NOR? That's your homework. You will have many homeworks this week. This is one of them. Now, finally, XNOR. So I will be merciful with you. I will not add it to the homework. So let's do it. And we'll leave again, you know, the implementation of XNOR using NOR gates as a homework. Okay. That's an easy one. We just, it's exactly the same as, you know, the implementation of XOR. Let's see. So the first, so basically first the function of XNOR is F equal to XY plus X bar Y bar. So this is XY and here is XY and X dot Y totally bar. Then the second implementation is, second term is X bar Y bar. So the output is X bar, Y bar, totally bar. And to make an OR gate, we need the inverted versions of the terms that we're gonna OR them together. And we have them already. We have them already. So we don't need to do, you know, something like this here. Okay. That's the difference between algorithmic thinking and optimal thinking. We usually do the algorithmic thinking first, get something that is working, then we optimize it. Then we go to the second NAND gate. So the output here is X, Y bar dot X bar, Y bar bar, then totally bar. This will give us X, Y bar bar or X bar, Y bar, 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 X, Y plus X bar, Y bar, which is exactly the XNOR gate. And again, how to implement XNOR using NOR gate, that is a homework. Okay, guys. So just a conclusion for what we see in that lecture or part of the lecture six is that NAND and NOR gates has a very, you know, great property or advantage is that we can implement any other logic gate like AND, OR, NOT, XOR, XNOR using either NAND, either or NOR. So your final design can be basically implemented using only NOR gates or NAND gates. You don't need to include OR or NAND. And that will make your design simpler, less complex, and your timing analysis for calculating the delays and the stuff will be also similar, because you only have one type of delay, the type of NAND gate delay or NOR gate delay. If you have a mixed design with NAND and NOR, you know, and here or here, inverter here, then you will have, you know, more complex analysis for your timing of your signals, because the delay of NAND is different from the delay of OR, different from the delay of AND, because these are different circuits. Okay, guys. So next time we'll continue with the properties of NAND and NOR gates. So see you in the next video. Bye-bye.